Welcome back to English Classes Online. My name is Benjamin. In today's video, we are going to look at 7 rules for using tag questions in English. If you are new to this channel, kindly subscribe to the channel by clicking on the subscribe button below. Make sure you click on the bell icon as well, so that whenever a new video is uploaded on the channel, you will be notified instantly. I have a free PDF file for you in the description box below. The PDF file teaches about the basic units of English grammar. You will find it very useful if you are desirous of learning English grammar. So just click on the link in the description box and you'll be able to download the PDF file free of charge. You will also find an ebook titled Good Success in English. It is my ebook, which is an all-encompassing ebook, a complete study package for effective English learning. The ebook deals on different key topics of English, teaches different key topics of the English language, ranging from the writing skills, which of course includes all the forms of writing, whether it is essay writing or story writing or article writing or speech writing or report writing or any of the other forms of writing. They are all adequately explained with clear samples in the book. Then you also find comprehension, various chapters of the book discussing comprehension, summary writing, lexis and structure, the various grammatical units and structures, ranging from morphemes to words, from words to phrases, from phrases to clauses, from clauses to sentences. And then you have the various rules, various grammatical rules of the English language, then the spelling rules, the punctuation marks, the oral English, phonetics and phonology, vowel sounds, consonant sounds, stress patterns, and name it, all right? All the areas of language proficiency in the use of English are all adequately treated in the book. You will find the book quite interesting and helpful. In addition to all this, the book also contains past questions and answers that will enable you to prepare for your English exams. And all these are all there in the book. So if you are interested in getting a copy of the ebook, just click on the link in the description box and it will take you to the book page where you can grab your own copy of the book easily. Now, having said this, let's dive into today's lesson right away and look at the 7 rules for using tag questions in English. First of all, what is a tag question? A tag question or question tag is a short clause at the end of a statement that turns the statement into a question. It is a short question you add to a statement in order to get a confirmation from the hearer. For example, the guests have arrived. That is the statement, haven't they? So this is how the question tag works. You make a statement and then you add a tag. You add a question, a short question to it. Now, you may have noticed that 2 terms have been used here to refer to this concept, question tag and tag question. They mean the same thing and can be used interchangeably, all right? So let's now move a little further. Why do we use tag questions? Number 1, to confirm whether something is true or not, all right? And then, of course, when you are in a conversation with someone, then perhaps there is something that is supposed to be known to both of you, but you want to verify from your hearer, the person with whom you are discussing. You want to confirm, you want to make sure that both of you are on the same page. Now, you can also use tag questions to elicit agreement or consensus. Of course, it's similar. When you want to confirm something or to verify something, you want to make sure that both you and your hearer, you know, are in agreement on that particular issue. And then the third purpose of the tag question is to emphasize a point, right? You want to draw your listener's attention to an important point. You can use a tag question. Well, let's now begin to look at the rules for using tag questions. Rule number one, the tense of the verb in the sentence must agree with the tense of the verb in the question tag. Let's look at examples. You are an electrician, aren't you? So you can look at the tense in the statement are, in the that simple present. Aren't you? The same simple present. Then second example, you were at the seminar yesterday, weren't you? So you can see that, you know, it will be wrong to say you were at the seminar yesterday, aren't you? So it will break the rule of sequence of tenses, all right? Then, example, I, Junior has returned from school, hasn't he? So the same simple present, all right? So let's now move to rule number two. If the statement is positive, the tag must be negative. So that is what we call positive negative, all right? For example, Rose is at home, isn't she? Now, is at home is positive. Isn't she is negative. So the statement is positive. Rose is at home. Isn't she is negative tag. So where you have a positive statement, you must have a negative tag. Example, I, she has swept the sitting room. So the statement is positive. She has swept the sitting room. So the tag has to be negative. Hasn't she? Example, I, the two girls are twins, aren't they? Positive statement, negative tag. Then, example, IV is a past question. The students will arrive soon, dash. You see, it's testing your knowledge of the rule number two, all right? The student will arrive soon. That is a positive tag. A positive statement. So you must have a negative tag here. And option A is correct. Won't they? The students will arrive soon. Won't they? So this question featured in 2019 Basic Education Certificate Examination. You will find it in question number 25. Now, example V is also a past question. It featured in 2019 Basic Education Certificate Examination. You will find it in question number 27. We all hope to get the best. That is positive statement. Dash is looking for a negative tag. And, you know, we all hope to get the best. There's another rule here. We all hope. Hope is a main verb. Another rule states that where you have a main verb in the statement, then the tag uses an appropriate form of do. All right? So we are going to look at it. Option C is correct. We all hope to get the best. Don't we? Don't we? That's the appropriate form of do. Because you cannot say hopen't we know. It doesn't work like that. Once you have a main verb, you use the appropriate form of do. All right? So the primary auxiliary verb do becomes what we call an operator. It operates to stand in for main verbs in certain grammatical constructions, such as the question tag. Wherever you use a main verb, then you use the appropriate form of do to replace it in the tag. We all hope to get the best, don't we? All right. Now let's go to rule number three. If the statement is negative, the tag must be positive. Rose isn't at home is a negative statement. Is she is a positive tag. Question II, she hasn't swept the sitting room is a negative statement. Has she is a positive tag. So that's the rule. Where you have a positive statement, you have a negative tag. And where you have a negative tag, you must have a positive, where you have a negative statement, you must have a positive tag. Example, I, the two girls aren't twins is a negative statement. Are they is a positive tag. Rule number four, the contracted form of the auxiliary verb is used. You must have noticed that we have always used the contracted form of the auxiliary verbs. Now let's look at the example. They have left Abuja, haven't they? So instead of saying have not they, we always contract it. You don't use have not they in a question tag. You always use the contracted form. They have left Abuja. They have left Abuja. Haven't they? Example, John is the new class captain. It's wrong to say, is not he? We use the contracted form. Isn't he? We change is to isn't. In the first one, we change have to haven't. We always change it to the contracted form, and then we present the contracted form in the tag. Example, I, you will visit grandma this weekend is, it uses the auxiliary verb will. So in the tag, we use the contracted form of will, which is won't. Won't you? You will visit grandma this weekend, won't you? So will changes to won't. Rule number five. If the main verb is used in the statement, then the tag requires the appropriate form of do. Remember, I explained it, when we looked at a past question. Now, example, Mark treks to school every day. Doesn't he? Doesn't is the appropriate form of do in this case. Mark treks to school every day. Doesn't he? Jack ate all the food. Didn't he? Didn't is the appropriate form of do. Dad and mom love each other. Don't they? Don't is the appropriate form of do in this case. Now let's go to rule number six. If the subject of the statement is a personal pronoun, it is usually repeated in the tag. All right? For example, the personal pronoun in example I is he. He is already here. Isn't he? We repeat he in the tag. All right? So it will be wrong to say he is already here and you say, isn't she? Or aren't they? No, it doesn't really add up. When you use a personal pronoun, you have to repeat it in the tag. He is already here, isn't he? It is all about he. Example, I. She left the office before the closing time. Didn't she? So it is she, it is she. Example, I. They didn't accept the offer. Did they? So they is in the statement and they is repeated in the tag. That's the rule. Then rule number seven. If the subject of the statement is not a personal pronoun, the tag uses an appropriate personal pronoun for the referent. Now, let's look at example I for clearer explanation. Mary is used here in the statement. It's not a personal pronoun and is the subject of this sentence. Mary has submitted her assignment. The appropriate personal pronoun for Mary is she. So hasn't she? So this is what we mean. When you use a word that is probably a noun, not a personal pronoun, then of course you have to use the appropriate form of the personal pronoun. I mean the appropriate personal pronoun for that particular noun. You know, a pronoun is a word that replaces a noun. So you have to use the appropriate pronoun that should replace the noun. For example, Mary here is replaced by she, a personal pronoun here. Then example, I, Olu and Benga are bosom friends. Now, the subject here is plural, Olu and Benga, and the pronoun that can replace Olu and Benga is they. Olu and Benga are bosom friends. Aren't they? So, Olu and Benga now turns to they, all right? Example, I, Mr. Okon is the new principal, isn't he? He replaces Mr. Okon in this sentence. All right, so these are the seven rules for using tag questions. They are the ones we have been able to cover in today's video. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure you like the video and share it with your friends and relations. We have looked at the seven rules for using tag questions in English. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. Make sure you subscribe to this channel and make sure you click on the bell icon so that whenever a new video goes live on the channel, you will be notified instantly. Don't forget, I have a free PDF file for you, which will give you further explanation on some aspects of English grammar. If you are interested in getting that free PDF file, just click on the link in the description box below and you will be able to download the free PDF. And then if you are interested in my book titled Good Success in English, a complete study package for effective English learning, whether you are learning English as a foreign language or as a second language or as an academic course of study, you will find the book extremely useful to you. So if you are interested in it, simply click on the link in the description box. It will take you to the book page where you will be able to grab your own copy of the ebook. I want to say a big thank you to all of you for being part of today's episode. I look forward to seeing you in the next class. Bye-bye for now and remain blessed.
Thanks for watching today's video. A big thank you to all of you out there for being part of today's episode. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, kindly subscribe to this channel. Subscribe now as a way of giving us support. For notification about new videos, click on the bell icon. You will find the bell icon. Click on it so that whenever a new video is uploaded, you will be instantly notified. If you have actually enjoyed the video, like and share the video with your friends and relatives. This is very important. If you have any comments, leave your comments below. Any questions, any suggestions, we would gladly receive them and respond promptly and positively to them. See you in the next video. I look forward to always seeing you.